The uterus is one of the most unique organs in the body. Before pregnancy, it is about the size of a lemon, measuring 7 to 8 centimeters in length and holding approximately 10 milliliters of fluid. At full term, 40 weeks, in a singleton pregnancy, the uterus expands dramatically. It can measure 35 to 40 centimeters long and hold about 5 liters of fluid, the fetus, and the placenta. In a twin pregnancy, the uterus stretches even further to accommodate both fetuses. It may hold 6 to 10 liters or more of fluid, placentas, and the growing twins. As the uterus expands, the mother may experience increased discomfort, increasing shortness of breath, acid reflux, and difficulty sleeping. Hormonal changes add to the challenge, combined with extreme fatigue, limited mobility, and fear of labor. These factors can take a significant toll on the mother's mental well-being. Additionally, the risk of gestational hypertension and gestational diabetes increases. Braxton Hicks contractions become more frequent and may be mistaken for real labor. Due to the higher risk of preterm labor in twin pregnancies, doctors closely monitor for contractions, cervical changes, and signs of early labor, sometimes requiring hospitalization. In the weeks leading up to delivery, the fetuses gain weight rapidly, though they may still be smaller than singleton fetuses. Their lungs continue developing as they practice breathing movements. The lungs are typically fully developed by 37 weeks of gestation, which enables independent breathing. However, more than half of twin pregnancies result in preterm birth before 37 weeks. In such cases, newborns may require NICU support to assist with breathing until their lungs fully develop. By weeks 37 to 38, the pregnancy reaches full term for twins. At this stage, induction or a scheduled C-section is often recommended, as carrying twins beyond 38 weeks increases the risk of stillbirth and placental insufficiency. Momo twins should always be delivered by cesarean section to avoid umbilical cord complications. About 60 to 75% of twins are born by C-section, but vaginal delivery is still possible in certain cases. Vaginal delivery of both twins are the most desirable outcome. However, the doctor may recommend a C-section if the first baby is lying on its feet, knees, buttocks first, or sideways, a low-lying or shared placenta, or a difficult delivery with a single baby before. In preparation for birth, the doctor assesses the fetus's situation via ultrasound. If both twins are head down, vertex-vertex, vaginal delivery is possible. However, if the first twin, called twin A, is in a head down position, and the second twin, twin B, is breech or transverse, vaginal birth may still be possible under certain circumstances. For all women with twin pregnancies attempting labor, regional anesthesia, epidural, is recommended, as it allows for the breech extraction of the second twin, a procedure that is difficult to perform without adequate anesthesia. Labor in twin pregnancies starts the same way as in single pregnancies, with contractions. The uterus begins tightening regularly, the contractions occurring every 5 to 10 minutes and lasting at least 30 to 60 seconds. The first amniotic sac usually breaks on its own. If only one sac ruptures, labor can still progress, and the second sac may break later. During labor, the mother's body releases a high amount of various hormones. Oxytocin stimulates contractions. Beta endorphins help relieve pain. relaxin, and estrogen make the pelvic ligaments, cervix, and vaginal tissues more flexible. After the water breaks, contractions intensify, helping push the baby down into the birth canal. The cervix gradually opens from 0 centimeters to 10 centimeters, allowing the baby's head to pass through. Because the uterus is already stretched, twin labor has a significantly shorter first stage than single births. Once the cervix reaches 10 centimeters dilation, it's time to push. The vaginal walls and birth canal are elastic, designed to stretch and expand without tearing, allowing the baby to pass through. The baby's skull is soft and can change shape slightly to fit through the birth canal. This is called molding, and it helps the head pass through more easily. Once the widest part of the head passes, the hardest part is over. The baby's head rotates slightly to help the shoulders fit through the birth canal. The doctor gently guides the baby's shoulders out, followed by the rest of the body. Once the baby's head and body are out, the doctor clears the airway and the baby takes the first breath. Once twin A is delivered, the doctor clamps and cuts the umbilical cord, but does not yet deliver the placenta, as twin B is still inside. After twin A's birth, doctors closely monitor twin B's position using ultrasound. With the extra space available, twin B may shift positions within the uterus. If twin B turns sideways, transverse, or breech, the doctor may attempt internal podalic version, IPV, in which the doctor inserts a hand inside the uterus to grasp the baby's feet and turn it into a breech position for delivery. This procedure requires high skill from the medical professional. If twin B stays head down, vertex, a normal vaginal birth can continue. The mother continues pushing. Twin B's delivery is usually easier than twin A's because the birth canal is already open. It is usually delivered within 10 to 30 minutes. Once twin B is delivered, the uterus continues to contract to help detach and expel the placentas. These contractions are usually weaker than those during birth. The doctor may apply gentle pressure on the mother's abdomen to push the placenta out. If each twin had their own placenta, dichorionic twins, two separate placentas will be delivered. If the twins shared one placenta, monochorionic twins, one placenta will be delivered. The doctor checks the placentas to ensure no pieces are left inside the uterus. Immediately after birth, each twin is checked for breathing, heart rate, weight, length, and head circumference. The babies are placed skin to skin on the mother's chest to promote bonding. If the babies are ready, the first breastfeeding session may begin. Twin mothers produce more milk, but establishing a feeding routine takes time and practice. Rest, hydration, and a diet rich in iron, protein, and vitamins are essential for maintaining the milk supply. After delivering twins and their placentas, the mother's body goes through a recovery process and the uterus starts contracting back to its normal size. This process, called involution, may cause mild cramping, especially during breastfeeding. Heavy bleeding, called lochia, occurs for the first 1 to 2 weeks. It then lightens and lasts 4 to 6 weeks. Clots are normal, but large clots or heavy bleeding should be reported to a doctor. Recovery may take longer due to higher blood loss and the physical demands of carrying twins. A twin birth is a major event for both parents, but the mother undergoes significant physical recovery and emotional changes. A supportive father or partner plays a crucial role in her healing process, both physically and mentally. Hormonal changes can cause mood swings, anxiety, baby blues, or even postpartum depression. It's important to be patient. Encouraging open conversations about how she feels can help her process the transition into motherhood. Let her know she is loved and appreciated for everything she's doing. Taking responsibility with diaper changes, bottle feeding, burping, and soothing. The father's role is not just helping with the babies, but also caring for his wife. Parenthood is a shared journey, and with love, patience, and teamwork, both parents can support each other and embrace the challenges of raising twins together.